Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. Last week we made the carriage stop for a dial indicator and you may have noticed that there was an extra hole on the end that wasn't used. So this week we're making a multiple stop fixture that rotates so you can dial in whichever stop you need. This is mainly for batch work when you have a lot of parts that you want different lengths to be accurate, and we use threaded bar and 6mm nuts to make the stops. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make it. This is a piece of 12mm mild steel. I just want to turn the end down to about 4.5mm. Now I want to turn the outside down 10mm. Okay. I'm just setting my parting off tool, put the square on the chuck up against the edge of the tool, slacken the tool holder off and move the tool holder until it's square to the chuck, then lock the tool holder. I'm just making another one exactly the same. My large centre drilling, and I'm only going to use the tip of it. Just holding this piece of off-cut steel that can just drop into. If I hold that in the vise, then a lot of the heat generated will go through the vise jaws. It'll take a bit longer to warm up. What I'm going to do is solder the ball in just so that I don't lose it. There's a bit of flux. This is just electrical flux. Small amount of solder in there and I'll put the ball in. Heat it up. And it normally bubbles at the bottom as the air escapes, and then and that ball's dropped back down there. You can see the air coming out, the ball's moving. And then as it cools down, the ball will stick to that hole. Now it's cooling down. Okay, so it's assembly time. So you take the spring that fits over this end, and the other end goes onto the... to make a little unit. The four-jaw chuck on the lathe, and I've put a 40mm diameter bar in there. I've just faced it, trued up the OD, and centre drilled it. Now I'm going to drill an 8mm hole.
With this 8mm hole, I only need to go about inch deep, because I'm going to be parting this off.
I'm just setting my tool post drill spindle.
And the way I've done that is I've put a centre in this end. On the other end, I've put that's an 8mm centre drill. And if you remember, we've drilled an 8mm hole. So I'll put that in the bore. Bring the centre in with the tool post and the tool adjustment slack. That lines it up between the two. If I put a little pressure on the tool post when clamping it, when I take this centre out, if this is adjusted too low, you'll see the end of the shaft go down. If it's too high, you'll see the end of the shaft come up. That's not moving. I can lock these up, the tool post and the tool height adjuster, knowing that the tool post drill is parallel up and down and also parallel in and out. So take the tailstock off. I know that the centre drill held in the tool post chuck is now zeroed. Take the drill out and swap it for the drill I need to use.
Wind the cross slide out 13mm and reset to zero.
I found a piece of metal I'm putting under the chuck jaw. I want to put four holes around this. I'm using the chuck jaw onto this block as a stop. I've used the chuck key just to hold the chuck onto that. I'm fitting my drill, electric drill on the end. And I'm just going to spot these four positions. Index round to the second position. Now, because I want to control the depth and drill that out to 4mm, 5mm, I'm not going to use my spindle post drill. I could do, but what I'm going to use is the pillar drill to do that. I've marked the position so I know they're in the right area. So the next job, take off all the sharp edges and part that off. Just changed my tool and I've put a chamfer on the inside edge. Return the parting off tool. Parting off tool broke. I've got a piece of parting off tool tip jammed in the steel, which I can't get out, so I can't use a parting off tool, so I'm just going to saw it off. Okay. Because if I'd have put another tip on and put the tool back in, the part of tungsten carbide that's been stuck in here would have only just smashed the next tool. So I'll just face this off now. So that's the part. I'll set the part in the pedestal drill. I've located on the hole centre that I've drilled. And I'm just going to drill through each hole right the way through with the 3mm drill. Changed to a centre drill and I've just picked up on the 3mm bore. I just used my drill to put to tap a 6mm hole. I'll just set the on this one. I've set the torque to about 13-14 for a 6mm hole. 8mm bolt that goes through the middle. It needs to stick out enough to go through this part, which is the dial indicator or carriage stop we made. That goes through here. This was the second hole I drilled in the bar. The dial indicator goes in this one. So you remove the brass bush that we made, put that through. I found it's easiest if you let the plunger go right in. Put the washer on first. Tighten this up. Tighten it tight and then just back it off a bit so you can move it. The ball bearing goes into the centre drill marks that we made on the back and locks it into position. So you lock up the block on the carriage, tighten these up. And then in the holes on this side, I'm just using 6mm cap heads, but you could use threaded bar, 6mm, just chop it to the length you need. This is just an example. You lock those in position. Then when you're doing repetition work, you can set these to wherever you need them or cut them down. So you come into that stop, then you can turn this round, move into that stop. Rotate it round and come into the second stop. It's mainly for repetition work, but it's another use of the block. So once you finish with this, you can put your dial indicator back in. You have got some adjustment on here with the nut, fine adjustment, but you need to get a bar. If you use threaded bar, you can just flatten the end of a threaded bar, but you may need to make this diameter bigger depending on how high your surface is, where the location of your stop face is. So on that you could put three in. Turn it to the next one. Turn it to the next one. You just need to check the diameter of these to your clearance on the top so that they clear.
Well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.